Monasteries in Europe became an important center of learning, order, and discipline. Now, monasteries simply are the places where monks dwell. How these monks came into existence in medieval Europe is further interesting. The monks who came here were those who were well-to-do Christians, and they moved from the region of Rome to Palestine, being fed up with the kind of corruption and the luxurious life in their existing empire. So these monks then started to work for the welfare of human race, and also they devoted life to prayer. So that was again an important thing. Now, when these monks started to move from the region of Rome to the region of Palestine, they mainly had a vision of helping the poor, aiding the various pilgrims to visit their holy places that they wanted to. And moreover, the idea was any disorder that was left should be removed, and people should be involved with the center of discipline and learning, which were the monasteries. So what happened in monasteries was very, very interesting. Lot of things were learned. For example, the art of animal husbandry, the art of craftsmanship, glass painting, wood cutting, mural paintings, all of these were learned. Schools were founded, incentives were given to people who wanted to read and write, shelters were given to travelers, widows were given protection, hospitals were built for the needy and the poor people, nuns used to teach as well as the preach the concepts. Now, when we talk about preaching, it was not just the religious education but also secular education, and lot of missionaries went to the non-Christian dominated lands and provided the concepts and preached and helped the people. This led to numerous reforms. Now, among all of those, Saint Bernard of Kalibrox is the one who is considered as one of the most ideal monks and the most influential monks of his time. Now, Saint Bernard's Kalibrox basically focused on the lifestyle and what are the rules and ethics that should be followed in the monasteries. Later, by 16th century, we have seen that there were numerous divisions within the Christianity itself. So Catholics and Protestants were the two major divisions, and at this point of time, the success of monasteries started to decline. The power and the downfall of monasteries was witnessed. So this happened with the beginning of Renaissance. After the Crusades, as we had seen from the impact of Crusade, the idea of art, geometry, science, maths was learned from the Arab and the Greek civilizations. And as a result, this prompted the concept of Renaissance in Europe. With Renaissance, there was a decline and reformatory movement, which was known as Reformation. And this Reformation was again a religious movement in 16th century, which was started by the Protestants, who were not that orthodox as Catholics, and they wanted to end the kind of monastic life in the nations that were ready to adopt Protestant religion or were the Protestant nations. This slowly started to spread to the regions where Catholic influence was high, and ultimately even in the regions where Catholic influence was high, with the development of Renaissance, a little of liberation in the policy and movement of the concepts away from the traditional boundaries were seen. So slowly the monastic life started to end and the monasteries started to decline, not only in the Protestant states but also in the regions where Catholic nations were there. Thank you.